Yes?
Carlton, will you go over to my office a moment?
Oh, all right. I'll be there just as soon as I can.
Really, I was anxious about you last night, darling.
I'm perfectly fit, thanks. Frightfully worried.
Arlene, you haven't started that again.
Now, don't stop moralizing.
I swore I'd never touch another stolen bond, and I mean it. I've been going crazy trying to get rid of all that stuff in the vault now.
Truly, sweetheart, I was forced into this.
Well, that's what you told me 2 years ago when you first started this. Arlene, you tricked me time and time again, and I won't stand for it.
Honestly, this is the end.
No, that's what you've said so many times.
Darling, you've got to help me this time because I'm in a jam.
Darling, how did you get tangled up in this racket anyway?
Well, I went into it with my eyes open. You can't imagine the terrific thrill out of walking around under the nose of the police, carrying hundreds of thousands of dollars worth of loot.
Do you realize what you're saying?
Well, it's all over now. We're going to be married.
Arlene, you returned those bonds.
No. I gave my word of honor I'd get rid of them.
Oh, you gave your word of honor. Well, that's easy. You're in the clear. They can't touch you. I'll be the one who'll take the blame.
Spence, don't be such a child.
And another thing. I've made personally for you over $800,000 in the market. And what have you done with it? You've hidden it from me.
I told you I'm putting it away in a safe place for my dowry. Should certainly satisfy you. Be a good boy and write me out a check for $50,000. A.B. Bouchard, usual.
Good morning, Mr. Bradford. It is good to see you again, sir. We miss you.
It's good to get back occasionally, Jim.
Now, do be careful, darling.
Don't worry, dearest.